Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Just a quick video here. I need to change the battery in my Breitling B1 watch. Basically has a pretty unique back, so it's not like you could just pop it off or use a regular watch tool. So I had to go out and I found the correct tool, I hope. It's basically what it is a watch die. And the code on it is 15-100. I believe it's a 36.5 millimeter. And that's what we're gonna use to connect to the back of the watch. We're gonna connect it to this to give us some leverage. And we also need a new battery. It takes a CR2320. I have a watch holder. And I need just a little tool because I'm probably gonna need to open up the band. So if you're wondering where I got this from, I got it from this company right here, Esslinger.com. And what I ordered was this die and this handle from there. And let's see, here are the part numbers for you. Or the SKU numbers, and you can see that it's not cheap. It was $80 for the die, and another $38 for this part right here. So basically, you're looking at $129. That's with the shipping, and I got the battery on Amazon for like $3. From what I understand, it's very hard to find a jeweler that has these parts, and they need to usually ship them out to Breitling, and it does take some time, so I can imagine it would cost at least $100, and I don't know. I figure I have the parts now. I could change the battery whenever it needs to be changed, and if I ever decide to sell the watch, I'll sell this with it. It might be a nice perk. All right, so let's get started. So here is the back of the watch. You could see it's kind of got what they call a turbine engine. Looks like an aircraft. And basically it has all these sides, it's 15 of them. And supposedly this is really the only tool you can use to get it off. All right, so just figured I'd show you what that looks like. But what I'm gonna do now is just open up the link so I could, put this on here and be able to go through. So I think what I'm gonna do is just pop out probably the pin right over here so that the band will be flat. Okay, so I'll probably have to do that. Let's see if I can do it on film for you guys. I'm just going right through here. Oh, there we go. All right, so you guys saw that live. And we just have to find where that piece went. But you can see now that the watch is now flat. Okay, and here's the pin that came out. Okay, so I have the watch connected to the battery watch holder, and now we're gonna hook up this piece right here to this. Okay, see that? Good, sitting there, nice. So here is, trying to get the best camera angle for you guys, but basically what we're gonna do is put this right on top. And looks like it fits. And now we're gonna hold this down. And almost came off too easy. I wonder if I could have got away with just using one of those silicone bowls. Okay, this might be a good opportunity to clean this part. It looks a little dirty. See, there's an extra little cap here. Just get that out with our finger. I don't want to get oils really on it. Okay, set that aside. And here we go. Here's the battery. And we'll just use our little tool here to pop this out. Let's see where we can get that from. Probably right here would be good. Okay, so I got the old battery out. Okay, take our new battery. These make these things so difficult to open. And I guess we should really look and see if things are working. So I'm going to loosen this up. And I'm hoping the blinking stopped. Well, it looks like we have almost like a reset. Yeah, so we're going to have to adjust the time and all that stuff, but what's cool is it's definitely working. That is probably the brightest I've seen it. Go back to all the other things. Let's see, PM, alarm, date, Monday, 1-1-1. Yeah, it seems like it's back to the beginning of time. All right, so we'll have to adjust that, but in the meanwhile, let's put everything back together. Okay, so we got the battery in, like I said, and we're gonna just pop this back on. As tight as we can with our hands, and now we'll use this tool. There you have it, folks. So, I would imagine the jeweler is going to charge you over $100 to do it. So, now I'll be able to do it myself, and I guess I could do it a little more often. Keep it in the date mode, which is what I like. Okay, so I'm gonna adjust that, put the links back together, and there you have it, folks. Another exciting video. All right, everyone. be safe. Thanks a lot.